Good morning, student. Today we'll be starting off our computer of standard 7. We move on to our next chapter, that is chapter number 2. The chapter number 2 is using Excel as a database. Okay, so this chapter basically deals with Microsoft Excel of MS Office or Microsoft Office part. Okay. Now the first thing that will be coming in your mind for starting this chapter using Excel as a database is what is a database. Okay, now as a definition, it resembles a collection of data. Okay, a collection of related table with data. A database is a data which is written in a systematic way, which is written in a tabular format. Okay, that is called database. Database contain all the related information of those things which you require. Okay, if you talk about our school is having your database. Okay, database means your personal informations, just like your name, date of birth, your mother's name, father's name. Okay, where do you live, your phone number, along with your marks of all the related subjects. Okay, that how many subject, whatever subject you study or how many subjects are there in your class 7, you will be the school will be creating a database. Okay, so that's all. Every record, each and every record is kept in the form of a database in a particular table, and the data are true. Data is organized data, it's not a raw data. Okay, the data is organized data. Now, the next point what we have is advantages of database. Okay, now you can see the advantage of database is easy retrieval of data. Easy retrieval of data means you can access the data. Okay, you can get back the data easily. Okay, you need not to search anywhere else. Whenever you will be looking for that particular data, you can get that data in that particular database. Now, reduction of data inconsistency. Reduction of data inconsistency means it's not that some data are missing, some data is you are getting some data or some data you are not getting. All these problems gonna be reduced. Clear. Next, easy manipulation of data. When you talk about easy manipulation of data means the data are to be manipulated in the sense with the help of that data you can do something else. Okay, so suppose there are different databases in the sense if personal information is kept on another database and your academic information is kept on another database, so you can easily manipulate it. Okay, next year when you will be moving to class 8, that class 7 is going to be removed and you will be going with class 8. So every year there will be a change in the data. Clear? This academic, I'm talking about the academic database. Okay, every year the data are going to be changed. Okay, each year, again next year you need to give the paper of English, you need to appear for the paper of maths, you need to appear for the paper of science. So each and every year the marks will be different, it will not be same. So easily the manipulation of data will be done. High data security means data loss or someone cannot steal your data. Okay, the databases are highly secure. Clear? Now, easy sharing of data. You can easily share data with someone. If someone asks you that if you have this data in your database, so you can easily get it. Okay, and you can easily share it with other persons. Okay, it's not that you need to search it from somewhere else. Reduction of data redundancy. Reduction of data redundancy means false data or keeping duplicate data, this all procedure is going to be removed. Suppose there is a boy who left this school, okay, although his data is there. Okay, so this is what, this is the data, this is the false data now which you are having. Okay, he's not a part of our school, so he has left, then also the data will be stored there. So if we use this type of databases, if we use databases like we can reduce the data. Okay, reduce the data in the sense false data will be removed, new data is going to be added. Okay, so that's what is reduction of data redundancy. Thank you. Now we have three more terminologies over here. One is field, okay, one is record, and one is field name. Okay, field is basically, we can say what we say is column. We know that databases consist of cells. Cell is the intersection of rows and columns. Now when you talk about field, we can tell that each type of data in a record is stored in column. Okay, so if you take this database, okay, so this specific column, this all are filled here. Now when you talk about data records, Excel stored record in each of these row. Okay, suppose Ram, Shyam, okay, his marks 81, 82, 76, 43. Okay, so each and every marks, it is stored. This Ram subject marks of both the subjects are stored over here. Okay, Shyam subjects marks of both the subjects are stored over here. So this is a specific record. Okay, and this one is the field. This one is a field. This one is a field of name. This one is a field of marks. Suppose math. This one is a field of suppose marks. What do we tell? If any other subject. Now field name. Now this all fields will have some name. Suppose this field name stands for name. This one is math. This one is science. Okay. So this is what we call the field name for that particular field. Clear? Now next part what we have is form. Now form is nothing, it is just a sheet where we can enter the data. You might have seen job forms or filling up some other forms manually. Also these forms are available online where specific names will be given and a place will be there. Suppose name like this, you can see if suppose name. Mobile number, address. Okay, so this the form will be of this type where specific names will be given irrespective of that names. Okay, on resemblance of that name, you can see beside one space will be there where you can write your name. Suppose XYZ. Okay, so you can write and fill up this form. Okay, once you fill up this form, at the bottom you can get one option as save, and if you click on this save button, the data will be stored permanently in your database. Okay, so each time you fill up this form, the data is going to be get saved permanently in your database. Now how to add form buttons. First step is click on file tab. Okay, you can see for each and every application software, there will be a file tab. You need to click on the file tab and you need to go to the select option. Okay, and you need to go to the select option of the backstage view. You can see there, if whenever you click go to that file tab and click on that select option, what will happen? The Excel option dialog box will appear. Excel option dialog box is going to appear. Now step 2, what we have, we need to click on the quick access toolbar on the left side, we can see at the top quick access toolbar will be there. You need to click over there. You need to select the command, this command, not in the ribbon option, from choose command from the list box. Okay, so what we need to do is not in the ribbon option from choose command from the list box. This is a other option. You need to select it from here. This option will come and you need to select it. Okay, that not in the ribbon option. You need to select that specific command. Next part is choose the form option from the list. You need to select that particular form option, that which form you have created. Okay. Now step 5 is what you need to do. Step 5, click the add button. There you will get an add button. Okay, after clicking on that add button, you click on okay. Okay, just press the okay button over there. The form button gets added on the quick access toolbar. So that form button will get add over near the quick access toolbar. Clear? So in this video, we learn about till here. This was adding form button. Okay, in the next video, we will learn about adding new records in a form. How we will be adding new records in a form. Okay, so till then, thank you.